Here I go now. Here I go in soon.
Fans, welcome to XPW TV. Now, we are just 2 weeks away from genocide, and the cage is currently in construction. We're going to have tremendous footage on that later tonight, but things have been getting very, very interesting, of course, of the kidnapping we saw last week. That's right, of GQ Money. I still can't believe it, Chico.
That's very, very mysterious circumstances surrounding the disappearance of GQ Money. Last week on the show, we seen GQ Money delivering a balloon to a very Chaney.
Hey!
Chaney, warehouse chico, knocking on the door, nobody answered. All of a sudden, a car screeches out of the shadows, chico, shadows. And two men, white masks, chico, jump out, and they grab the EQ money and they throw him in the trunk, chico. They kidnap him. His whereabouts, still unknown, chico. However, the good news, EQ balloons in West Hills, chico, in the Woodland Hills, still fully operational, chico, running the regular business hours. So don't worry.
I'm very happy to know that. Also last week, fans, Chaos continued his rampage. And of course, we all saw XPW Vice President of Operations Kevin Kleinrock giving us a medical update on the conditions of Rob Black. And for those of you who don't know by now, less than 2 weeks ago, Rob Black suffered a severe stroke. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to try to get the full update for you here on the show. But as Kevin Kleinrock was trying to update us all, Chaos came in during the update and attacked the Vice President. I can't believe it's still on his rampage, pal.
Chico, the Chaos, losing his mind, obsessed with capturing the double gold. Okay, but that is okay. I tell you why. Later on tonight, Chico, I will be interviewing the campeón, Chico, the XPW heavyweight champion, the king.
Oh, God, thank you. Because sometimes when you do that with that thing, my ears start ringing. And
what's that?
Wait. No! No!
That is right, fans. I will have an interview with Webb later on here.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Webb's going to be here tonight?
No, Chico. No, Chico. He will not be here. I will have the interview with him. Two stipulations to interviewing the king, Chico. First of all, no crisscross. The interview will be clause-free, per the request of the campeón, Chico. Stipulation number two, it must be in a secure, undisclosed location. All I can say, Chico, is Studio B. One of the subdivisions in Studio B has been arranged specifically for the campeón. Don't go away. Don't go away, fans. When we come back.
Wait. Studio B?
Studio B.
You know what, pal? That makes two guests right here tonight on XPW TV doing some investigative journalism is right here, pal, the host of XPW TV. That's right. I called personally Supreme at home, and I want some answers, pal. Of course, we saw the kidnapping of GQ Money last week on the show, and we all know Supreme a week prior attacked GQ Money. So I want to get some questions answered on this whole GQ Money situation. I got Supreme here this week. I got the better interview, pal.
Well, I got the king.
Nah, you got nothing.
Yo, it's been like an hour. Could you please see if Kevin Kleinrock came in? This is American Wild Job. It's me.
Okay, let me see what I find out. Hi, has Kevin made it in yet? Yeah, yes, I'm here, Sam. Oh, okay. Actually, no, he hasn't made it in yet.
You sure?
Yeah, that's what they're telling me, so. Give me 1 second.
Three door.
Good afternoon, Extreme. No, unfortunately,
she's unavailable
right now.
Oye, fans, in just a few moments, we're going back to the ring for some action at Freefall. But first, this portion of XPW TV brought to you by the home DVD, Blown to Hell, Chico. In this video, uncensored, ultra-violent crap, Chico. All the blood and guts you can handle, Chico. Now for the sensitive viewers, Chico. Right here, Chico. Blown away, blown to hell, the exploited rematch between Big Grimes and Supreme. Right here, for your own viewing pleasure, you can run it in the slow motion, fast forward to see all the violence that these two individuals put on each other. Not only that, the extremely, take a good look, Chico, the graphic, very nice, close to the butt. The three-way championship match between Webb, the Sandman, and Vampiro, all that, and all the other action, from Halloween in Hell 2001, Chico. Order the DVD on the website, right here.
I will be taking this copy home. Now, this is cool. This is kicking, yo. This is really a cool DVD, and I'm gonna take this home. Fans, that night at the Pico Rivera Sports Arena will go down in pro wrestling history and forever be remembered as one of the most extreme matches in XPW history. But history will be made of its own Saturday night, April the 27th, as XPW presents Genocide Now. Of course, we got two teams, apparently of four, going to be battling inside of an 18-foot-high steel cage with two rings at the Olympic Auditorium. Fans, this is going to be the big man. Once again, Genocide comes to you live Saturday night, April the 27th, from the Grand Olympic Auditorium in the heart of downtown Los Angeles. Now, tickets are going fast. I don't mind telling you. Remember, two rings, that means less seats in the arena. Of course, you can get your tickets through XPW Box Office at 818-755-8757. Come on down to the box office at 11133 Van Owen Street, Suite Letter D in North Hollywood. Go to xpwrestling.com or you can get them through Ticketmaster, 213-480-3232, ticketmaster.com or any Ticketmaster outlet right here in the Southland. Fans, it's going to be Saturday night, April the 27th. XPW presents Genocide, proving to be the biggest card in XPW history. Now, fans, when we return here tonight on the show, we're going to take you back to the Grand Olympic Auditorium at Freefall. At Freefall.
Well, well, well.
Critics doubted it, but the fans demanded more. Japanese hardcore wrestling is back. Harder than hardcore. More intense. More extreme. More in your face. More in demand. Hosted by Joel Gertner and Buck Woodward, WK Media presents Japanese Hardcore Wrestling 2, Sunday, April 28th on pay-per-view.
5150 Tattoo and Body Piercing. Body art for the insane by the insane. Come see why they're number one with great artists and sterile facilities. Safety and satisfaction guaranteed. Then stop by CD Warehouse. The best prices and selection around. Gift items like t-shirts, hats, stickers, and more. Plus, they also buy and sell used CDs and DVDs. 5150 Tattoo and CD Warehouse, corner of Laurel Canyon and Victory. Get there today.
I'm Joey Styles. Vince McMahon and the WWF don't want you to know what I know. I have secret sources inside the WWF locker room and inside the WWF offices. I have all the news that you're not supposed to know. Plus, all the news on your favorite local wrestling promotions. Call the number on your screen now.
Mr. American Wild Child, sir?
Yo, he's here.
Actually, he was here, but he had to go to a luncheon meeting. Do you want to leave a note for him or something?
Did you tell him it was me?
I told him that people in the lobby waiting for him.
You said it was American Wild Child.
Yes, I did, sir. Unfortunately,
it's really important I see him today.
He's not in right now. He had to run to go to a luncheon meeting. Like I said, you could either wait for him longer or if you want to leave a note. Usually luncheon meetings run an hour or two.
That's important I see him today.
Okay, you can wait longer if you like. Okay.
But let me know next time.
I will, as I find out.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, I guess things are a little better this week, but I'm still under a lot of stress, you know, and, you know. Yeah, exactly, with the wedding and all. Yeah, we'll be doing that. Exactly. And just, the bills are piling up. I mean, the money's still coming in and everything, but, I mean, Rob's medical bills are getting pretty expensive, and, I mean, you know, I was going to try to afford to get, like, you know, now that he's not in the match, I was going to try to bring in, like, Shorty Mack or someone to replace him, but, no. And then I've got this idea. I'm trying to work on, like, getting Joey from NSYNC to come in and, like, sing him, like, you know, Get Well, Rob, or something, or, you know, Wind Beneath My Wings, or, you know, Get Over Your Stroke or some kind of song like that, but I don't know, man. The Insane guys want a lot of money, and I tried trading them for a product, but, you know, I don't know. Anyway, I gotta go grab Angel. We're gonna go by the hospital. I gotta go by his office. Yeah, can you believe that? We gave Angel an office. We fired some retard, so we put him in there. Yeah, he's like designing it his own or something. I don't know. All right, it's good talking to you. Talk to you later. Bye.
Yeah, baby. You know how to talk to me. No, I'm just in my new office. Yeah. They fired that retard that used to be here. And so they gave me this brand new office. I mean, it's decorated kind of good, but I'm going to put a little bit of some Angel touches up here. Some handcuffs. Yeah, you remember from that from last night, huh? Ooh, yeah, I like that butt plug too. Let's see what else we got here. Wrap on. Oh, I got your picture too. Yeah. Right here. I'm going to put it right by me. That's right. I'm glad they fired. Oh, yeah, I'm glad they fired that idiot. Now I have my own office with a picture of you. Oh, and I'm glad you dumped that fat. What was her name? Emerald? Oh. Yeah, Michael, I'm thinking about you. You know what? At Genocide, in the main event, when I win the world title, the world title.
Well, well, well.
Critics doubted it, but the fans demanded more. Japanese hardcore wrestling is back. Harder than hardcore, more intense, more extreme, more in your face, more in demand. Hosted by Joel Gertner and Buck Woodward, WK Media presents Japanese Hardcore Wrestling 2, Sunday, April 28th on pay-per-view.
5150 Tattoo and Body Piercing. Body art for the insane by the insane. Come see why they're number one with great artists and sterile facilities. Safety and satisfaction guaranteed. Then stop by CD Warehouse. The best prices and selection around. Gift items like t-shirts, hats, stickers, and more. Plus, they also buy and sell used CDs and DVDs. 5150 Tattoo and CD Warehouse, corner of Laurel Canyon and Victory. Get there today.
I'm Joey Styles. Vince McMahon and the WWF don't want you to know what I know. I have secret sources inside the WWF locker room and inside the WWF offices. I have all the news that you're not supposed to know. Plus, all the news on your favorite local wrestling promotions. Call the number on your screen now.
He's super sexy.
Yes, he is.
I couldn't help but overhear him. But, did you say something about winning the world title?
Were you stopping?
No, I was just walking.
Were you listening to my conversation?
I'm going to go see Mr. Black. I just thought maybe I'd come by and ask if you wanted to come with me, and I just happened to overhear as I'm walking up.
No, I think you heard wrong, okay? I think you got a little bit of juice in that ear. Maybe squirted. Miss-wordedness? You heard wrong, okay? I didn't say the world title. I said the television champion. I'm gonna get Chaos. But see, there's two things I want around Chaos. They're both around this area. One being the title, and the other being his,
Michael knows about that?
Yeah, he does. But let's go see Mr. Black. Come on. I'm all ready. I got every... Kevin, come on. Who's that?
I'm making the car.
Kevin.
Is your cash or you drive separately?
Kevin! Kevin.
Supreme was in the ring talking about the dismissal of Vampiro and Conan here at XPW. Now, the Sandman took great exception to that. And all of a sudden, the West Coast icon met the East Coast icon to determine the XPW King of the Deathmatch.
Oye, chico, it would be a dream match for many of the fans that would turn into a nightmare for one of the participants. Check it out.
I've been with XPW since the beginning. And we keep bringing these bull superstars out here that don't last. I started this for myself to get myself over, but now I'm doing it for all of you. Now those other pieces of like Vampiro, Conan, Sabu, all these motherfuckers come out here for the money. They don't give a about anybody else. That's not what XPW's about, and that's why they're not here. XPW's the only place with the Deathmatch title, and we do it for you. We've got workers here from day one. Look at this. Where else are you gonna see this? Now all I'm saying is all these supposed superstars. Who am I? What's this company? Yeah!
Look at this, the Sandman! The Sandman coming out to confront Supreme! One of these superstars that he was alluding to! The Sandman coming to the ring now to confront none other than the XPW King of the Deathmatch, Supreme!
You know what this man's problem is? He's a whore! This man's a whore!
Whoa.
But he's not a whore for a pimp. He's not a whore for himself. He's a whore for you stupid fans.
Whoa, where the hell is Sandman coming from right now?
I don't know, I ain't confused.
Yeah, you're the whore. Hey, you're the guy that comes out here, I'm the king of the Deathmatch. Hey, I ain't seen anybody die lately.
Wait, without
Sandman? A little bitter right now.
Sounds like it.
So, you can do all the crazy crap you want in the ring and get paid $75 for it. And these bus stars are taking home the money. Yeah, you're a whore for them. Or maybe you're a mark for yourself.
Oh, sick.
But I'll tell you what. You will not catch the Sandman putting somebody through a table anymore in this building.
What? Where the hell's he coming from?
You will not catch the Sandman beating somebody over the head with a Singapore cane.
What?
You will not see me hit somebody with a chair anymore because I happen to be one of those superstars, and I don't give a damn about these fans.
Where's this guy coming from?
You know what? I don't even care about that damn thing anymore. I'm a superstar. I can wrestle.
I can't believe that one.
Let's see if you still got some balls. What's your come for a title tonight? The Deathmatch!
Well, look at this, Supreme challenging the Sandman. Kick. What is this?
And everyone say.
Tick. Tick. Who would have thought that the day would come
right now? Deathmatch! Let's not get the out here! You want it? You want it?
Wow. Look at this Sandman. A little trepidatious now.
First of all, us stars don't wrestle in preliminary matches.
Oh, come on!
See, you're the type. He tore himself for somebody stupid like you.
Tick.
You know what? You want your death match?
Betty, strong words.
Who am I?
Well, well, well.
Critics doubted it, but the fans demanded more. Japanese hardcore wrestling is back. Harder than hardcore. More intense. More extreme. More in your face. More in demand. Hosted by Joel Gertner and Buck Woodward, WK Media presents Japanese Hardcore Wrestling 2, Sunday, April 28th on pay-per-view. I'm Joey Styles. Vince McMahon and the WWF don't want you to know what I know. I have secret sources inside the WWF locker room and inside the WWF offices. I have all the news that you're not supposed to know. Plus, all the news on your favorite local wrestling promotions. Call the number on your screen now.
The following matchup is scheduled for one fall with no time limit, and it is for the XPW King of the Deathmatch Championship.
What is he, Sandman, now?
What the hell is Sandman doing here and no music? He's storming into the ring. What is this all about, Sandman?
Introducing first, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, the challenger, this is the Sandman!
Tickle, very interestingly, he did not bring his own weapon.
Not only that, this is the quietest I have ever heard a crowd with the Sandman's entrance. But don't think you're going to hear a quiet crowd now, because the King of the Deathmatch Supreme is coming to the ring to defend his title against the Sandman.
Not only to defend his title, Kinkle, but to stand up from the fans here and then beat all the streets. You recall that the Sandman called Supreme a whore, Kinkle.
That's right.
Supreme, saluting on his man.
To bring the giant down. because it's Sandman, scary, intensely, and supreme. And supreme makes the celebratory traditional walk around the ring to salute on his neck. Jacob, to me, it's unbelievable the way Supreme, he is the champion of the Heel in Deathmatch, and still, he is the one that issues the challenges. No one challenges Supreme, he challenges his opponent. Jacob, it is a hurdle.
His opponent from Hollywood, California, he is the human horror film and the defending XPW King of the Deathmatch champion. He is Supreme!
Supreme! Now defending his King of the Deathmatch title. Against the man who, in recent times, is maybe one of his toughest opponents. But Supreme has gone through some battles.
But the Sandman, this is a different Sandman, Chico. I don't know who the hell this guy is or where he's come from.
Chico, he's very near, very, seems to be very nervous to be in the ring with Supreme.
He now to the midsection, Snapmare takeover from the Sandman onto the big man Supreme. Going for a chokehold now and going for wrestling moves. Uncharacteristic, this could be very smart boy on the part of the Sandman, of course. In a deathmatch, you hardly see moves like this at all, Chico.
Chico, might be a good game plan to try to defeat Supreme and stay away from the tools of terror, Chico, the implements of destruction.
The tools of terror, I like that one.
Chico, you feel free to use it, Chico.
Well, I may steal it.
Chico, I believe, look, the Sandman is trying to choke out the Supreme before they can get anything.
Choke him out right now, but Supreme, luckily, he got that foot to the bottom rope and ultimately forcing the referee to break the hold.
Chico, very smart by the Sandman to try to stay away from the barbed wire and the thumbtack and the desert nails. Chico, try to wrestle Supreme.
Supreme now, look at him staring. Look at the Sandman staring back at him. I mean, this is war. Supreme. Supreme wants to have his way with the Sandman. You heard what he said earlier. You heard what he said about these big supposed stars coming to XPW. And the Sandman, oh, just barely snagged himself on that barbed wire. Supreme with the boot to the midsection now. And look at this, Sandman just barely sliding away from that bed of nails. That was close.
Jacob, the Sandman is trying to be very resourceful to stay away from the implements of destruction. Jacob, he had a very, very little taste of the barbed wire, and that was enough for him ducking out of the ring while he was sent to the bed of nails. Jacob.
Once again, both of these men fighting around this huge 40-plus-foot scaffold. I mean, this thing is higher than the balcony here at the Grand Olympic Auditorium, fighting around it with amongst all these weapons. And look at Supreme. He can't wait. He's putting this into the ring. Supreme putting the bed of barbed wire into the ring. And the Sandman, he doesn't know what to think. Look at the look on his face.
Jacob, apparently the Sandman seems to be out of his element.
Sandman now stomping away on the back of Supreme, back of the head.
Very cagey maneuver by Sandman, away Supreme to enter the ring so he can take the advantage.
Oh no, Supreme, look at this. Sandman now with that bed of barbed wire. What the hell does he have in mind here? What the hell is he doing?
Chico, he wants no part of the barbed wire.
He's throwing it out of the ring. That's the first time ever. Oh, Sandman! Chico. Right into that barbed wire!
Chico, they weren't on Avera. That had to hurt.
Ecole la chinguda. As Sandman went right at the end. Look, he's still caught.
He's caught in the barbed wire. He can't get out. And Supreme now, like a lion, stalking his prey, Chico, all over the Sandman.
Like a predator indeed, helping Sandman out of that the hard way, if you will. And look at this now. Going out there, putting the Sandman's head right into that bed of nails, Chico.
Chico, you can't get any closer look than the nails the Sandman is looking right now. Tufetón a la frente del Sandman. Supreme is in complete control, Chico.
Sandman now. This is one of the most cautious, most slow death matches I've ever seen because of the Sandman. Obviously, the Sandman wanting to prove a point
that he doesn't have to go through this stuff because he is this big superstar? Give me a break, man. I can't believe I'm even saying this about the Sandman. Where the hell is he coming from?
Jacob, even though he is trying to stay away from the barbed wire, it is...
Oh, look at that!
Oh, Jacob, right onto the barbed wire table.
As you were saying?
Jacob, there is nowhere you can go. You may try to avoid... Oh, Jacob! Mira, Sandman, by the grace of God, lifted himself and Supreme cut all of the table. And now Sandman, rubbing the barbed wire
to
the back of the head.
Look at that!
Oye, oye, mira! Mira already busting Supreme wide open with the barbed wire, and the Sandman also bleeding profusely.
Profusely indeed, I mean, it's like a crimson mass now coming down the face of the Sandman. But the Sandman grabs the steel chair. Supreme caught still in that barbed wire.
Jacob, you saw the Sandman rub the barbed wire right in the face and the head of Supreme. And now, all of a sudden, both of these competitors are busted wide open.
And look at the blood. Look at the blood flow. Look at the sweat. Look at both these guys. Like two warriors going at it now in this death match. And now look at even the Sandman's getting into the spirit of things.
What is he doing now using the chairs?
Sandman with something in mind.
Supreme has blood in his eyes, trying to regroup Jacob. Oh!
Boot down to the midsection. Sandman getting caught from King of the Deathmatch Supreme. Once again, both men busted wide open. And look at this.
Belly-to-belly
suplex. Beautifully executed. Chink from Supreme. Look at this now. Supreme forcing referee felony to set this bed of thumbtacks. And it looks like Sandman had this in mind earlier. I mean, he's the one that set these chairs up.
What is going on, Chief?
As they set the bed on these four chairs. The thumbtacks, look at that. Thousands and thousands of thumbtacks. Being utilized soon to be utilized in this match, Supreme. Look at so maniacal setting that bed up as the Sandman. You see the look on his face, the blood running down his face.
Chico, the Sandman is out of
it. Oh, no! Oh, look at that!
Oh, Chico.
Just setting him on that bed of thumbtacks alone. You can see the pain.
Chico,
the Sandman. Supreme is going upstairs. The Sandman.
Oye, mira. The Rock Superstar KO, Chico. Interfering, now punching his uncle, Chico.
What the hell is this?
Chico. Is that Rosano? Rosano attacking Supreme from behind with the Singapore King.
What the hell is going on here? Damn it, no!
The EQ Money, the Media Man, and you're also up on the ropes with Supreme. See what is going on?
Look at this! Oh my God! No, please, no! No, hey, no!
Chico, no! King! That don't count! What is going on? What is this? What is going on?
Here is your winner and new XPW.
No!
This is Deathmatch champion.
No! No!
Sandman.
No! Damn it, no! You gotta be kidding me! There's gotta be another ruling!
Who do these guys think they are? The Enterprise interference! What is this?
What is this? The Sandman is now with the Enterprise?
No lo creo.
What the hell is going on tonight?
No lo creo.
The Sandman is the new XPW King of the Deathmatch Champion!
¿Qué es esto? Veronica King making her way down here.
Oh! What is going on? Major Gun!
Disappointed. Jingle, she is disappointed in the Sandman. She had no idea that he was going to turn and join the Enterprise.
She looked totally disgusted at the Sandman. Walking by the Sandman. Major Gun!
Coming to
help out Supreme! Oh, and what help he's getting. Oh. I can't believe it. The King of the Deathmatch is no longer the King of the Deathmatch.
That is unbelievable, Tinko. It's going to take a while for that to sink in, Tinko. I cannot believe it.
It's going to take it a while for it to sink into me, pal.
My belt, dude! My belt! Sandman! prize! My belt! It's all what the
Chaos, man. I didn't win no world title. But you're still the TV champion.
But you see, the fact of the matter is the Enterprise has double gold.
We do have double gold.
The Enterprise has an extra member.
We do have another member.
The elite member. An icon.
An icon for sure, but you see what that did to my hair? They say that I'm balding, dude, but this is ridiculous. Dude, I don't know if I
can do this. You just got one thing I understand. When you mess with the Enterprise, you're going to mess with Chaos, the most unstoppable force in XPW. Mouth of the West is simply the best.
And don't forget about this one. He might be bald, but we got a hell of a lot of gold to cover it, baby.
Gold. Lot of gold.
Yeah,
gold.
You
got a drink for me?
Hey, go ahead. It's vodka, baby.
Vodka. Sex, drugs, rock and roll. You can't beat the E. We live the life. Y'all feel the strife, baby.
Deathmatch.
Ooh, what a night.
You know, Sandman, you are really f***ed up. You know, I actually thought you were the man, but you got another thing coming. This is the real f***ing hardcore man. So if you want to be a man, take some lessons from him.
Ladies and gentlemen, fans, how strange was that? Very, very highly reminiscent of the night that the Enterprise lit Supreme on fire. Not only do they get involved, his life again. They also take away his title, Chico. They steal it away. Unbelievable, Chico. Just like the night that they lit him on fire. This has lit a new fire under Supreme yet again. No pun intended. Big guy, tattoo guy, I love you, man. I love you. Don't get mad at me. I only read the lines, okay? Anyways, back to the thing. Chico, Chris Claus on his way back. From I don't know where he was. I think he was looking for Supreme.
You know, apparently Supreme has already come and left.
Look, lady, I've been here for like 4 or 5 hours. I really need to speak to Kevin Kleinrock. It's really important. It's American Wildchild. Get on the horn, do your job, and get
okay,
it to him.
Okay, sir, unfortunately, he is on the phone with one of our big East Coast customers, and he has to speak with him before 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. You could wait a little bit longer. It shouldn't be too much longer. I could almost guarantee that to you.
Look, lady, between you and me, you know what's going on here. I know what's going on. So do me a little favor. You know, I worked one of those Ultimate Wrestling shows last week, so I made a few extra bucks. And maybe you can make the time go by a little quicker.
You want to add a couple zeros, and maybe I can?
This is all I got.
Not enough, darling. No. Sorry, as soon as he's off the phone with the customer, I will let him know
I'll
you're
wait.
Still here.
I'm gonna wait.
Okay.
Anyways, Chico, you finish up with the fans here. I'm on my way to the undisclosed location in Studio B.
You're going right now?
Right now, Chico.
Wait a minute, whoa, whoa. Hold the phone and stop the horses, pal. You're gonna interview the Champ Webb right now?
Right now.
Oh! Wait.
Okay.
Gosh!
Finish up here, say goodbye all right. To the fans for me.
As they say in Germany, adios. Fans, we got some show info for you right now. Now, as well as the genocide match we all know that's going to be going down Saturday night, April the 27th, you're also going to see stars like Pogo the Clown, Vinny Massaro, Confederate Currency Chris Hamrick, Evan Courageous, Psychosis Hoovy, and if we're all lucky, the SoCal Jobbers Union!
Well, you know what, sir? I hate to do this to you, but it's 5 o'clock and that's the time I go home. So I've got to have the lobby cleared out. Do you want to leave a note for him?
No, yeah, it's real cool. I'm just going to hang out and talk to him. It's really important.
And unfortunately, you can't. I've got to, when I lock up the door, I've got to make sure everybody's cleared out of the lobby. So you could, like I said, you could either leave a note or come back tomorrow and try it that way.
All right.
Sorry
man.
Oh, who's that? Come on in.
Rivera. You know, the interview?
Oh, that's right. Okay. Can you make it back in time or no?
I guess. I don't know. Can't wait. You gotta go now?
You gotta go now. Visiting hours are over in like a half hour.
All right.
So you staying or you coming?
No, I'll just walk out with you then, I guess.
Just sign that dollar.
Hey, why don't you put some clothes on, you know?
I don't know if the hospital's gonna let you in like
that. Would it be so horrible for you, like, to put some pants on and go to the damn hospital?
Why do you wear a light?
Who?
Well, well, well. Critics doubted it, but the fans demanded more. Japanese hardcore wrestling is back. Harder than hardcore. More intense. More extreme. More in your face. More in demand. Hosted by Joel Gertner and Buck Woodward, WK Media presents Japanese Hardcore Wrestling 2, Sunday, April 28th on pay-per-view.
5150 Tattoo and Body Piercing. Body art for the insane by the insane. Come see why they're number one with great artists and sterile facilities. Safety and satisfaction guaranteed. Then stop by CD Warehouse. The best prices and selection around. Gift items like t-shirts, hats, stickers, and more. Plus, they also buy and sell used CDs and DVDs. 5150 Tattoo and CD Warehouse, corner of Laurel Canyon and Victory. Get there today.
I'm Joey Styles. Vince McMahon and the WWF don't want you to know what I know. I have secret sources inside the WWF locker room and inside the WWF offices. I have all the news that you're not supposed to know. Plus, all the news on your favorite local wrestling promotions. Call the number on your screen now.
Fans, in addition to all the stars we know that are going to be at Genocide, the question is, will Vic Grimes, will New Jack be in attendance? Now, we have not seen or heard from either of them since Freefall. Fans, these questions will be answered Saturday night, April the 27th, live from the Grand Olympic Auditorium in the heart of downtown Los Angeles. Once again, tickets are going fast, I don't mind telling you, but they are still available now. You can get them through the XPW box office at 818-755-8757. Come on down to the office located at 11133 Van Owen Street, suite letter D in North Hollywood, or you can go to xpwrestling.com, now Ticketmaster as well. Call them up at 213-480-3232, ticketmaster.com, or any Ticketmaster outlet right here in Southern California. A big show coming up, the biggest show in XPW history, Saturday night, April the 27th, from the Grand Olympic Auditorium at 8 p.m. Now, if I can get a hold of the guy, we got word that the interview's going down right now, so bear in mind, we're going to try to get through all the technical mumbo-jumbo right here. Chico! Rivera! Rivera, go ahead, we got you, pal.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here with the campeón, Webb. Okay, he granted me this very, very special interview time. We know he's very, very busy, but I'm very, very happy. I'm ecstatic. He grants me 5 minutes of his time. Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, the first question, Webb, thank you very much for joining me after months of me asking you. I really appreciate it. Let you know, Cornu, right here, man, mi corazón. I support the Black Army and Webb especially. But let me ask you, in the minds of all the fans and me personally, what is the condition of Mr. Robert Black?
Well, Mr. Black, by the way, I'd just like to thank you, Larry,
for having me here. No, please,
thank you very
please,
much.
No,
very, very good thing. I'd just like to say that Mr. Black is, condition is improving, but things, you know, still kind of murky. He's not completely out of the woods yet, but we'll see how it goes.
But he's appearing.
He's a day-to-day.
Really? So, in question then if question. He will be at the show on April 27th. Ladies and gentlemen, tickets.
Yeah. Well,
the other thing that all the fans want to know, being that this is the double ring, a steel cage match, all the titles on the line. We know that Chaos is obsessed with the double gold, Chico, but what I'm wondering is, now that Webb does have the opportunity to win the double gold also, which title is he going to choose to go after, the Deathmatch title against the Sandman, or is he going to attempt to make the television champion Chaos submit?
Well, see, you made a little faux pay right there, you see, because what you said was double gold. And I believe some other bozo is going around telling everyone about double gold. But as you know, we in the Black Army, we don't subscribe to that. We prefer to say triple gold.
You should have in the first place. Giving me my title shot. Giving me my double gold. You wouldn't be here right now. I would beat your ass three times. Four times. Five times.